So, good morning, my dear students. Once again, welcome to Grade 11 Accountancy class. Okay. So, the previous discussion, we started to learning how to prepare ledger posting from the preparation of journal entries, how the entries transfer from journal to ledger. So, now you take one exercise from our NCERT book. From that, we are also learning balancing. Ledger posting and balancing also. See, it will be more useful for you to learn easily. Once again, for preparation of ledger posting and balancing. Okay. I will going to discuss my NCERT book, page number 94, exercise number 16. Okay. There you will see one by one transaction, business transaction. Accordingly, I will go into to the ledger posting. Okay. So now you take that page number 94, exercise 16. So what is the first one? Generalize the following transactions post to the ledger. So they are asking post to the ledger. Here we are also learning how to do balancing. Okay, end of the session we understood how to do the balancing. So what is the here? Totally some 15 transactions there. It is occurred in the month of November 2017. Okay, what is the first one? November 1, 2017. Business started with cash and goods. Okay, so how to do the entry, you know, whatever date you have to mention. So November 1, 2017. What is the entry? Cash account data. How much? 1,50,000. Okay, so 1,50,000. Thereafter, they mentioned goods. See here, you are going to write goods. Goods you can write in the stock account. Okay, 50,000. When you started the business, they are bringing the goods also. That's what business started with, not only cash, 1,50,000. They are going to start with the goods. Here you can't write goods, you can write stock. Okay, how much? 50,000. To, you know, capital account. So capital account. It will say capital in the form of cash and goods. So total is here 2 lakhs. Okay, this is what? Journal entries, narration being business started with cash and goods. Okay, that is narration you have to write definitely. So how we are going to do, you take the whatever the book, take the book like this. Okay, so firstly you take the book, just to take the book. Okay, so you have to start journal entries one by one. So whenever journal entries, you give two spaces, or even two spaces better. Here some 7 entries, here some 7 entries. We are going to start ledger, just page one by one. Start here, ledger one by one. Okay. So, any journal entries here, immediately you are going to start ledger one by one. Accordingly, you have to follow, you have to work out. Okay. That's what we are going to learn. How to do the journal entries. See, here you are going to do simultaneously, you are going to do ledger post. Right? Simultaneously, how you are going to do. That is very important. Understood. Simultaneously, journal entries. So, thereafter, due to the space purpose, we will adjust here. So, what is the first entry? Cash account data 1,50,000. Stock account data 50,000. To capital account 2 lakhs. Okay. So, how to pass, how to open a ledger? So, always here cash account. Okay. I open cash account. Always when you open the cash account, you have to give more spaces. Okay. You have to give more spaces because the cash account, the number of transactions is there. So more transaction. That's why give the number of spaces here. Okay. So you have to open first the cash account. How to posting? I said the always posting, we consider this. Okay. So to capital account. Okay. To capital account. So here I put center point. So, my data, my creditor. Okay. Debtor and creditor. So, what is the entry? To capital account. So, date is very important. So, year 2017, November 1. To capital account. How much? 1,50,000. So, I write it here. 1,50,000. So one part is over, one debit part is over, under the cash account, I have to open to capital account. Understood? Then, we want to open another account. Okay, stock account. So, I have to give spaces here. Okay, stock account. So, what is the entry again here? Same date. So, November 2017 to capital account. To capital account, how much? 50,000. Capital account, 50,000. Okay, so 50,000. So debit part is over. Cash account data to capital account 150,000. Then stock account data to capital account 50,000. Now we are going to open which one? Credit part. Debit part you open two. Now cash ledger going to open what? Capital account. Okay. That's what we are. Cash ledger. Capital. Capital account. So how to write? Say November 1, 2017. The date is very, very important. Okay. By cash account. By cash account. Okay, one part. By cash account. So debit I return. Credit in a capital account. By cash account, 150,000. Okay. Similarly, by stock account. So by stock account. By stock account, how much? 50,000. Okay. So see carefully, my two debit part over. Cash account 150 in my cash account, to capital account 150,000, then stock account to capital account 50,000. So two debited, similarly, two credited. Double entry system. Okay. Divide corresponding debit, there is a corresponding credit. That's why you have to work out the posting. You understood the first entry is over. So whenever you do the journal entries, immediately, simultaneously, you have to practice ledger posting. Okay. Now see what is second one. Second one, November 3, purchase goods from Harish. Okay. So here naturally what type of purchases? Credit purchases. So what is the entry? Entry here? Purchases. I will do the just purchases account data. How much? Purchases 30,000. Okay, so 30,000 to Harish account 30,000. Okay, it's all your general entry. Narration, what you have to write? Being goods purchase run credit. So how to do the posting? So you have to check whether I opened purchase account already opened or not. So now we are going to open two account. Purchase account, Harish account. First you have to open which one? Debit part. Okay. So I put number for each understanding. This cash 1 over. Then this is 2. Then this is 3. So fourth account, I am going to open what? Purchases account. Okay, purchases account. So, what is the date? Date is very important. Date is 3rd November. So, November 3rd 2017. Purchase account data to Harish account. To Harish account. How much? 30,000. Understood. So, well, this part is over. Now you want to open which account? Harish account. So I put it here, 51 Harish account. Harish account. So by date November 3, 2017, by purchases account. How much? 30,000. Understood. The second entry is what? Purchase account data to Harish account. In a purchase account, two Harish account 30,000. In a Harish account, pay purchase account 30,000. So we done it our second journal entries. Correct. You understood wrong. So narration I have not written, you have to write narration. Being goods purchase on credit. Because they given the name, party, creditor. not purchased on cash. Okay. Now see the third one. Third one, November 5, sold books for cash. Okay. Third one, sold books for cash, 12,000. So what is the entry? Sold books for cash. What is the entry here? Sorry, here. Sold books for cash. So entry is what? You got cash. Cash account data. How much? 12,000. To sales. Okay. 12,000. Correct? This is cash sales. Simply got money. Cash account. Trail account. Debit what comes in. Sales account. Nominal account. Okay. Credit, all income and gains. Date. Which date? Date is 5th one. So we will verify. Already cash account is open. See carefully. Okay. So I put date is what? 5th. So just I put it all November. November I put it in. So this is 5th one. 5th November. Okay. To sales account. How much? 12,000. Okay. Cash account data. Cash account data. To sales account 12,000. I want to open which one? Sales account. Okay. So this is the my 6th one. Sales account. Okay, sales account. What is how to pass the entry? The date is November 5, 2017 by cash account. How much? 12,000. You understood? This is our third journal entry. Cash account data 12,000. Cash account data to sales account. In a sales account, by cash account 12,000. Corresponding debit, then corresponding credit. Okay, understood. Here also I put debit and credit. So likewise, in your book, to keep it open, ledger, whenever you enter the journal entry, pass the journal entry, which is already there, no need. So it is a new one, you want to open one by one like this. Okay. Now see the what is the 4th entry? See, 4th entry, very important entry, interesting entry. Cash, sorry, 4th entry is what? November 8. Purchase furniture for cash, 5,000. So purchase furniture for cash, 5,000. What is the entry? Write it here. As a furniture account, how much? Furniture account, 5,000. Cash. Okay, furniture account, 5,000 to cash account. Okay, 5,000. So how to pass the entry? So first, I have to verify. So furniture account has a real account because of the asset, debit what comes in. Cash account also real account, credit what goes out. So now we find journal entry. How to do the ledger account? So we have to verify. So we want to open what? Furniture account. Okay, I put number 721. Furniture account. Okay, furniture account. So what to write first? Debit card. Always write debit card. That's how open furniture account. So date is furniture account 8th August. November. So November 8, 2017 to cash account. Okay. To cash account 5,000. Okay. Debit card is over. Furniture account to cash account 5,000. So again, already cash account open. So I have to put date. So November 8, 2017 by furniture account, because cash goes out. The subsequent chapter will study the cash account separately. So debit is coming under pay receipt column. This is whatever money received on cash. This is payment. So now you paid money. So cash goes out. That's why buy furniture account. How much? 5,000. Understood? That's what our the 5th entry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4th entry. Purchases furniture for cash. Here, you be very careful. You have to debit the asset account. So furniture account is open. Not purchases account. Okay. See, any asset purchase, you have to mention asset account only. Asset account data to cash account. That's why open. Furniture account data to cash account 5,000. Then any cash account, buy furniture account 5,000. So what way my cash goes out? I mentioned here. Here, what way I got cash? Through in the form of capital account, through in the form of sales of. I got cash. Here, my payment in the form of furniture. That is the information you can get from the preparation of the cash book. That's one of the important ledger. Okay. Then thereafter, what is the next one? November 10th, cash paid to Harish on account. How much? 15,000. So one payment, already purchases Harish account. Here. So what you have to do? You have to pay some payment. So what is the entry? Has Harish account? Harish account debtor to cash account. So already open Harish account. So what is here? Some general entries and directly posting. That also you have to learn now. Okay. So what is the entry? Anyway, pass the entry now. What is the entry? So once payment, part of payment they paid. Which one? Date? 10th. Okay. So 10th November. So November 2017. 10th November. What is the entry? Harish account debtor 15,000 to cash account. Okay. So derivation you have to mention being cash paid on account. So we purchased on 30,000. Now on particular date after purchases on 10th November, we make it some part payment to Harish. Entry Harish account at all to cash account. How much? 15,000. So how to make this general entry? All the Harish account is there. Okay. So no need to open once again. Okay. So what is in date? Date is 10th November 2017 to cash account. How much? 15,000. So this debit part I am going to write first. For say for sake, always debit part you have to write. Harish account debit card to cash account 15,000. So automatically my cash reduces. Cash goes out. He is the receiver. Personal account. Debit the receiver. Personal account. Harish account. I mentioned. Cash cash account coming under real account. Cash goes out. Okay. Credit card goes out. That's why every time we want to verify whether we are following our golden rules. Okay. So what is the now cash account? What is the date? Again. So November 10th by Harish account. 15,000. See, the decimal is very, very important. The comma and the C zero I am writing. That's why the placement of amount is very, very important. So then only it's very easy for you when you do for the calculation. Okay. So for us in the main exam there is no calculator. So, you should be placing properly. Then only our work as an addition subtraction very easy. Okay. Then you understood this entry, correct? As a Harish account data to cash account. Okay. Then, what is the next one? Next one, November 30, sundry expenses, they given 200 rupees. So, entry is for sundry expenses account data to cash. So, I have to open here, sundry expenses account. See, sundry expenses account. So what is sundry expenses here? The question arises. See the yields, we cannot classify some small amount like that. We can put it as sundry expenses. We can also call, later on we can study, miscellaneous expenses. Okay, miscellaneous expenses. Where is miscellaneous? Miscellaneous. So what is miscellaneous expenses or income? Nothing but, we can't identify the yield. We can transfer to that head of the account is miscellaneous expenses. So expenses which is cannot be identified for particular head, that's why we can transfer to miscellaneous expenses or as income for miscellaneous income. Similarly here, they can transfer to sundry expenses. Okay, you understood. Sundry expenses. So what is the entry? Sundry expenses is the debit part, nominal account, expenses. Two cash, how much? 200 you paid. Which date? Date is November 13th. Okay. So November 13th. I put November 13th, 2017. Two cash. Account. 200. Debit part over. Credit part? Again, November 13th by sundry expenses. 200. Understand? Now sundry expenses, two cash account 200. In the cash account, buy sundry expenses 200. Debit part and credit part to generate in a proper manner. Okay. Thereafter, what is next? Once again, cash sales, November 15. So what is the entry, you know, what is the now cash sales? Cash account data, two sales account, already we done it. Okay. Cash account data, two sales account. So what is the entry? Cash account data, two sales account, date is 15. Amount is again 15,000. So November cash account data, so November 15, two sales account. 15,000. Then the cash sales. Cash account data, two sales account now 15,000. Again, you have to write credit part. Okay, November 15 by cash account. Again, cash account 15,000. Okay, understood. That's what's very, very important for your question. In a cash account, two sales account 15,000, date, it was happening 15th November. General entry, cash account data, two sales account 15,000. In a sales account, November 15, by cash account 15,000. Here, a corresponding debit, a corresponding credit. Posting. Okay, you done it correctly. That's what you have to do simultaneously. So it is easy for you because you never miss the transaction. Sometimes what will happen? First you write all the general entries. Then you go for the ledger posting, you miss it the maybe debit part or credit part. So finally what will happen, you will get the error. Okay, that's why, so whenever general entry one by one prepare, simultaneously keeping an open ledger also, posting also you can get very easily. Okay, then what is next? Next is deposited into bank, November 18. How much? 5,000. So what is the entry? So deposited into bank. So our cash goes to bank. So debit bank account data. Bank account data. What is the value? Value is 5,000 November 18. Okay. So 18 November bank account data 5,000. To cash account. Okay. Cash account 5,000. Narration we have to write. Being cash deposit into bank. So bank account maybe the any name of the bank. Representative personal account. You studied already, na? The three type of personal account. One is a natural personal account. Thereafter, artificial personal account. Third one is a representative personal account. Maybe the Indian bank or Canada bank. That bank name. So receiver. Deputy receiver. Similarly, cash account. Coming under real account. Credit what goes out. So, bank account. Our cash goes to where? Our bank. That's why cash credited. So, how to pass this entry? Here, we want to open what? Bank account. Okay. I will open here bank account. 9th one. Bank. Okay. Bank account. So entry. Which date? 18-11. So 18-11. 2 cash. Account. How much? 5,000. So in a bank, I write 2 cash account. Similarly, here November 18 by in a cash by bank account. Okay. In a cash can write bank account. How much? 5,000. My cash reduced here. When my cash going to reduce here, then it is increased in bank account. Right. Bank account data to cash account. So later on studied in the cash book. This is called contra entry. So now itself we can learn one small information. So this is called contra entry. Okay. So whenever cash withdrawn or deposited, it is called contra entry. Bank account data to cash account. This is called contra entry. Subsequent chapter discussed when you do for the hour preparation of the cash flow. Now here also you can learn another important point. Okay, so bank account data to cash account 5,000. In a cash account, by bank account 5,000. This is called contra entry. So what is the meaning of contra entry? Whenever cash withdrawn from bank or deposited into bank, we can say it is called contra entry. Okay, simultaneously you can do it. Okay, that's what our this one, this information. Then, next one is November 20. Draw cash for personal use. 1,000. You know very well. So what is the entry? November 20. Personal use. So naturally, you can say drawings account debit, correct? Any personal, you have to debit what? Drawings account. So cash, draw cash for personal use. So withdraw money for personal use, not office use. That's why drawings account debit to cash account. How much? 1,000. Okay, this is a guarantee. So what is your debit card? I want to open drawings account. Okay, 10th one, drawings account. Drawings. So this is the ledger with the name of the head. Okay, so date is, which date? It was happened in November 20. So November 20, 2017 to cash account 1,000. Okay, my drawings account 1,000. Then in your cash account November 20 by drawings. Okay, how much? 1,000. So one of the very important entry for the any personal use. Similarly, purchases also, you know, any goods withdrawn by personal use, what is the entry? Drawings account data to purchases. Same manner here, cash withdrawn. So drawings account data to cash account. So asset drawings account to cash account 1,000. Coming for the cash account by drawings 1,000. Here debit part, here credit part. Okay, we done it. Just general entry for posting. Thereafter, see, very important one. November 22, cash paid to Harish in full settlement account, 14,700. Thereafter, they just given settlement. So how much is supposed to be Harish account? See, just to see the example, they purchased 30,000. So Harish already paid cash 15,000. So supposed to be 15,000. How much he paid? Only 14,700. So remaining 1,300 rupees, we considered for what? It is called discount received. But in your book, they are not mentioned. They are simply given settlement. Settlement means the 300 considered as a discount received. Now you see how first to pass the journal entry. So what is the entry? The date is what? Date is 22. Paid to cash. Okay, I have written here in the space. So, for example, 22. What is the entry? Cash paid to Harish. Okay, so Harish account. Actually, Harish account, how much? 15,000. You have to pay 15,000. How? Whatever 30,000 purchase, you already cash paid 15,000. So difference how much? Naturally 15,000. That's what I mentioned at his account. 15,000 debit. Then only you can understand very clearly. Actually, how much I paid? Two cash account. How much I paid? Only 14,700. That's what my credit card. So what is my 300 rupees? That is called to discount received account 300. See, now my debit part is what? 15,000 supposed to pay a rich account. So two cash account, only 14,700 only I paid. Balance 300 I consider discount received account. So we discussed already for this transaction how to pass as a discount allowed and discount received. You understood this important entry, especially it has happened November 22, a very important entry. So how to make it entries here? So first you go to Harish account, debit card. Debit card is simply where you write. What is the date? 22-11. So 22-11 to cash account 14,700. Okay. Harish account to cash account 14,700. Again, to discount received account. So two accounts you have to mention. That's what. In Harish account, two corresponding credit debit I have to write. In Harish account, data, two cash account 14,700, two discount received account 300. So, debit part is over. Now coming for the cash part. Okay. Here I am going to write. So what's the date? Date, you know, November 22, correct? So 22. Again, November 22. I have to write by Harish account. How much? 14,700. Only this part. Net cash. Net cash account. By Adish account. 14,700. This what you have to do, sir. So you have to open discount received account one of the ledger. Okay. So I have to write. Just put it some 11. I put it here. 11th number. You have to open discount received account. Under that, you have to open this end. By Adish account here. Date 22-11 by Adish account 300. So here, what is the idea? The information here as a discount received. When you open discount received, suppose how many parties you want to know, how many parties enjoying discount received. So what is the entry here? As Adish account, as a personal account, debit the receiver. Okay. So how cash account, as a real account. Credit what goes up. Okay. Then discount received coming under nominal account. Credit all income and gain. Here he consider 300 rupees is a gain. That's why in the Adish account, I pass to cash account 14,700 to discount received account 300. Then in a cash account, by Adish account 14,700. Again I open discount received account by Adish account 300. Okay. So in a two debit part I done it. In a Adish account, see two debit part I done it. Okay. This two debit part. Two debit part I done in a Adish account. 42 cash account 14,700 to discount received account 300. Then, one credit part I done it here. This credit part. Another credit part I done it here. Understood. That's what here open. Three posting. One here Adish account. Then cash account. Again, you want to open discount received account. That's what three information. Three posting you have to do. One, two, three. Okay, three posting you have to do. So very, very important posting. As understanding of any discount received you enjoy. How to pass a journal entry. Okay, so understood for November 22 for this one. Okay, then goods sold to Nitesh November 25. This is considered what? Credit sales. So November 25, say goods sold to whom? Nitesh account. Credit. How much? 7,000. So date is November 25. Nitesh account data 7,000 to sales account. Okay, 7,000. So this is when you see the journal entry, you understood. This is what happened. This is coming under credit sales. Nitesh account data, personal account, debit the receiver. Nitesh, how much? 7,000 to the form of sales account, normal account, considered as an income. So how to post this? You verify anywhere Nitesh account is there. So there is no Nitesh account. So I want to open. So this is my 11th one. My space here I open. My 12th one. Nitesh account. Date is, which date? November 25. So November 25 to sales account. How much? 7,000. So debit part is over. Open Nitesh account, two sales account, 7,000 over. Then sales account already open. Date is same, November 25. By Nitesh. Nitesh account, 7,000. You understood? That's what this entry. Okay, this is the entry. Nitesh account data to 7,000. Two sales account. This is Nitesh account, two sales account. Nitesh account, two sales account, 7,000. Then sales account already opened November 25 by Nitesh account, 7,000. This is considered as credit sales. You understand now? Just see the transaction all very easy. Okay, that's what you can be able to clearly identify. Okay, so almost we pass some 10 entries, correct? Okay, 10 entries. Thereafter, next one. Cartage paid. What is cartage paid? November 26. What is the entry? You know, cartage account data to cash account. So here cartage account anyway want to open. Okay. So I will do here. This is my 12th one, 13th I will open here. 13th. Cottage account. Okay. Date. November 26th. Okay. So November 26th to cash account. What is my cottage? 200. Okay. 200. I done it. Cottage account data to cash account 200. Similarly, I'm going to write November 26. 26. Correct. November 26. November 26. By cottage account. How much? 200. Understood. Corresponding debit cartage account data to cash journal entry. Cartage account data to cash account 200. In a cash account by cartage account 200. Okay. You understood like this. You have to carry on for the remaining journal entries. Okay. Next you will see November 27. Rent to pay 1500. First journal entry, rent account data to cash account. November 27. So what is the date? So we have to open rent account. Okay. So rent account, and because no space here, I will open here. So rent account. Rent account. Number is 14th one. Correct? Let's get number 14. Okay. So date is 27. Correct? 27. So November 27 to cash account. How much? 20 rent account, rent 1500. To cash 1500. Okay, so this is it. And you make it two part, 1500 to cash account. Okay. Rent account. Journal entries were rent account data to cash account. So rent is coming under normal account, debit all expenses and losses. As a cash account coming under real account, as a cash goes up, credit card goes up. So now, date is 27th, November 27. By rent account, how much? 1500. Okay. Then, next one, it's very important. November 29, see, received cash from Nitesh, 6800. So we done it sales, na? And the cash, here, yeah. Nitesh to sales account. When? November 25, how much you sold? 7000. But we got money, how much? Received cash from Nitesh, 6800. So they give a discount allowed 200. So how to do the journal entry here? Okay. So what is the amount to receive cash account data? How much is 6800? Actually, so how much Nitesh has to receive? How much Nitesh has supposed to pay to us? 7000. Okay. So I write it here. To Nitesh account. He is the giver, correct? He's supposed to pay how much? 7000. But this is given money only 6800. So naturally here, discount allowed account. So where credit and debit? Debit and credit qualified. Cash account data 6800. Discount allowed account 200. To Nitesh account 7000. Okay, that's why we received only 6800. So naturally 200, we consider discount allowed account. So how to pass this journal entry? Earlier we done it what? As a sales, as a purchases we got discount received. Three journal entry you have to pass. Correct. So here, first already cash account, it is there. So what's the date? Date is 29, correct? Yes, 29. So I put 29, Lauren. To this one, this for debit for cash account. How much? 6,800. Then another debit part, I want to open which account? Discount allowed account. Discount allowed account. I will open?
Yeah.
Okay. No space. Ah, here I will open. Button. So 14, 15 I will open here. 15. Discount allowed account. Date is 29-11. Okay, so 29-11. Two, I have to write whose name? In a cash account. Sorry, I have to write wrongly written. To Nitesh account, correct? In a cash account, to Nitesh account. To Nitesh. Okay. Cash account data, to Nitesh account, 6,800. Then I open discount allowed account, 2911. To Nitesh account, how much? 200. Correct. Two debit part is over. Now coming for the Nitesh account. Here Nitesh account. I have to write this two part. Date is which date? 29-11. So 29-11 by cash account 6,800. Then this debit part, I am going to write credit part by discount allowed account 200. Okay, I repeat once again, very important entry. Cash account data 6,800, discount allowed account data 200, to Nitesh account 7,000. So how to do posting? First this part, always debit part you have to write. Cash account data to Nitesh account 6,800 only. The amount is very important. Again, I open discount allowed account data 2911 to Nitesh account 200. This part over. Okay, two debit part over. Now, coming to the Nitesh account, by cash account 6,800. Here, debit part, here, credit part. Similarly, discount received account. Here debit part, here by discount allowed account, credit part 200. You understood? So this is very important entry. So whenever you have to approach for the discount allowed account and discount received account.
Correct.
Discount received account. Somewhere you can it. Discount received account. Where drawings account, here discount allowed account, Nitesh sales, and here discount received account. It's very important one. Then discount allowed. In a discount received account, I will give them the effect. Discount received account, I will give them the effect. So we have to go over name automatically will come. Who are the person who are given discount allowed? So who are the person who are enjoying as a discount received account? Understood? It's very important entry for this. That's why whenever you done the general entry, immediately we can do the posting. See, I was telling the mistake here. First I return to cash. How in cash account, now the cash account will come. So that's why cash account data to Nitesh account. That's why simultaneously when you do for posting, mistakes you rectify. Maximum avoid mistakes. Okay. Then finally, salary paid. 3,000. Okay, already done one exam. Here salary paid, November 30. So what is you have to open salary account? Okay. So the last one. So this is my 15. I put it here. 15. Salary account. Okay. Name of the head. November 30. 2017. To cash account. How much? 3,000. Similarly, in a cash account, November 30. By salary account. How much? 3,000. Okay. So this is comma. Don't think it is one. That's why the comma you should be put very carefully. Okay. So these are all comma is very important. Okay. To identify the decimal. Two salary account. So entry is what? Salary account data to cash account. Salary is coming under why I am debiting is coming under nominal account. Debit all expenses. Similarly, cash account is coming under real account. Credit what goes out. So salary account data to cash account 3000. Debit part is over. In a cash account, November 30, by salary account 3000. Sir, 3000 debit part, 3000 credit part. So we done it almost 15 general entries. Then we done the posting. So due to space purpose, somewhere I am written. Okay. So in your notebook, we are keeping on open, ledger one by one. Put a number. So number, I given number na, cash account 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And where is my 11? 11 somewhere. 10, 11, 12. This is 13, 14, 15. Okay, this is 11. Yes, 11. Okay, 11. Likewise, number you have to give. Then finally, my 16th one. Totally how many ledger? You know, 16 ledgers. How many journal entries? 15 journal entries. So now we done our second important part. We done the journal entries, then we done the ledger posting. Now the third one that is very important, balancing. That's what we're going to learn now. So what is balancing here? Okay, so very important factor, balancing. So now first you consider, that's why given the space here. Here, first all you are making two equally parts. So in a cash, always cash is a debit balance. So for example, cash never get negative balance. Correct? Cash always is a positive balance. Definitely balance in your hand, cash is there, some amount. Okay. So as a debit part, first you want to total it. Okay. So what is our debit part total? Coming under how much? Okay. So you see here 1 by 1, 0, 0, then 8, 10, 6 plus 5, 11, 13. 1. 5 plus 1, 6, 7, 8. So total is 1,83,800 credit card. Same amount, you can write it here. Same amount, 1,83,800. So after the adjustment of all this, what is my balance? Okay, that's what the our November 30. What is my balance? That is called, that's what balance is. My balance. You put C bar D. What is C bar D? My balance carried down. C bar D means what? Carried down. Carried down. What is the balance right now? End of the month. So what are my cash received? What are my payment? Ultimately, end of the month, November 30. Suppose it is December, December 31st. So November 30, you have to write by balance carried out. How much? That's what we're going to learn. How we're going to learn. It's very important thing, balancing and learning. See here, everything is zero. Okay. Here also it is zero. So normally speaking, I first write the answer. So for example, when you total it, you get it. So balance is one, I will do it the balance. Here all the zero. Thereafter, see here also zero. So at the time here also I put in zero. Then here 2. 2 plus 7, 9. 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 5, 16. So total is up to here 16. Here only 8. So I consider 18. So balance is 2. Correct? 16 is there. I consider here 18. Naturally, I put 2, 18. So this one, I carry over here. I repeat once again. 2 plus 7, 9, 11, 16. But here, 8. So in the 16, I can't adjust 8. That's why I put 1 decimal before prefix. So I consider 18. So naturally, what's the difference? Up to here, 16, I got 8. Here, I consider 18. Difference is 2. That's why I put 2. So balance 1 carry over here. Okay, when we practice number of times, you understood how to get balancing here itself. So 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 5, 16. 16 plus 1, 17. 17 plus 4, 21. Okay, here 21, here 24. Here up to 24. Here how much available? Only 3. So I considered what? I put more than 24. So I considered 33. So what's the difference? So what's the difference? So naturally, difference is what? 33 minus 4. Yeah, correct. So here, again repeat once again, 5 plus 1, 6, 11. 5 plus 1, 6, 11. Thereafter 16, 17, 21, 24. So I considered 24 here, I considered 33. So I put it, the balance is what? Amount is 8. Okay, difference is 8. Okay. 33 minus 34. For 9. Amount is 1500. Okay. Salary account 300. Oh, sorry. Here, rent account is 1500. So, rent account is 1500. Open rent account. Yes, 1500. 1500. Okay. So, amount is here 25. I repeat, one second. What are the carryover? 1. 1 plus 5, 6, 11, 11 plus 5, 16, 17, 17 plus 4, 21, 22, okay, 22, 22 plus 3, 25. So, I consider, we are only 3, so I consider 33, so 33 minus 25, 8. So, what's the carryover? This 3 I carry over. Okay, so 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Then here only 8. Directly I put it 3. 5 plus 3, 8. Here balance only 1. So what is the balance now? 1,38,200. So we got the balance. So how to write? We have to write this for our next month opening balance. So that was first December 2017. We have to write 2 balance. To balance brought down. How much? 1,38,200. So likewise, we have to do balancing. Asset cash account, it is a number of transactions more. Actually, what you have to speak, you want to total it, then up to this part you have to total. Correct. Up to this part you total, then you deduct. So that will take much time. Therefore, whatever total it is, always cash book is a positive balance. That's why debit balance is more than the credit balance. Okay, so first we have to calculate here 1,83,800. Then coming for the credit side, I have to calculate 1,83,800. And differences, I set the idea how to do. I repeat once again for this calculation, once again. So here all 0. Here also all 0. Okay, then 2 plus 7, 9, then 11, 16. So, when I come to year 16, but here only 8, that's why I consider 18. So, 16, 18, difference is 2. So this balance 1, I taken as 18, na? This 1, I'm carrying over here. So, 5 plus 1, 6, 11, 16, 17, 21, 22, 25. So, here only 3, I consider more than 25, that's why 33, difference is 8. So what is the carryover? Carryover is 3. 3 plus 1, 4, 5. Here only 8. So 5, say 8. Difference is 3. So this one, then nothing is here. That's why 1 lakh is I carry over here. So what is the balance? 1,83,800. After adjusting the payment, my cash balance right now, 1,38,200. This is called by balance carry down. 1,38,200. Then 1st December, again, I am going to write 2 balance brought down, 1,38,200. Same manner, you want to work out all. So here, only 1 balance, that's why I put double underline. Again, I want to close 30, 11, by balance I'll see one by one by balance carried on how much 3000 so whenever one single transaction put double underline again you carry over here December 1 okay 2017 two balance dot down 3000 that is next month opening balance similarly start upon I put double underline when a single transaction you can put like this okay so 30th November 2017 by balance carried on 50,000 okay a double underline I bring it here December 1 2017 two balance drop down 50,000 okay then I want to close capital account so I want to close capital account how to write so only the two transaction here so likewise more the kind of more number of transaction single transaction you can do it double underline here two more transaction here total here 2 lakhs okay 2 lakhs I put date here November 30 2017 two balance carried on first which part is that opposite side you have to give effort the two balance carried on what's the total 2 lakhs okay 2 lakhs 2 dash 2 lakhs so I have to bring credit side December 1 two balance drop down 2 lakhs okay so my capital account always credit balance you know in our normally as a diabetes here capital also credit side okay then purchases account put double underline date December 1 see December November 30 by balance carry the 50,000 double underline then I put it December 1, 2017 to balance brought down. How much? 30,000. Okay. Same manner, your cottage account also double underline. You have to transfer like this. Rent account, my discount receipt account. Double underline. I put November 30 to balance. Carry down 300 double underline okay 300 then I will put it for the opening balance December 1 by balance brought down okay brought down means opening balance okay carry down means closing balance now see Harish account both side tally so no balance in see 30,000 Harish account nil understood similarly our Nitesh account also nil see 7,000 here also 7,000 closing so wherever balancing only we have to cancel otherwise account closed no need to balance here Harish account closed whatever purchases I done my payment okay 30,000 here it total 30,000 over with a second 7,000 similarly my 7,000 here over okay so both side 7,000 that is for balancing so it is nil account Okay. Then coming for the Arishakam, now sales. So I said total year sales. So 7 plus 5. 7, 34. Right? So 34. I want to total. 34,000. Then November 32. Balance. Carried on. 34,000. Then I bring forward opening balance. Okay, yeah. December 1. By balance. Drop down. 34,000. Okay. See, the purchases always debit balance. Sales always credit balance. Yeah. That's what by balance, drop down. And it is upon holder. Furniture account, likewise double underline, high balance carry down, good balance brought down. Similarly, sundry expenses, then your bank account like this, your branch account, similarly your salary account, same manner, you want to do balancing. You understood, here only the bigger transaction, it's a very important calculation. So once you understood the here, this level, the calculation of balancing, remaining is very easy. So only single transaction, you can put double underline, then you can carry over. So you want to close means particular month by balance carried down. Then you want to bring back in this month opening. Good balance brought down. Actually always cash is a debit balance. Expenses debit balance. Stock as asset debit balance. Capital account credit balance. Liabilities. Purchases account debit balance as expenses. Discount received is a credit balance. Gain. Okay. Then Arish account. Account nil. Suppose any balance you want to carry over. Whether it is a debtor or creditor. Here Arish account nil. Thereafter sales, always credit balance. Thereafter Nitesh account, bill account. Discount alone, always debit balance. Then furniture account, always debit balance, asset. Then sundry expenses, debit balance, expenses. Bank account, as a debit balance, as a asset, correct, 5,000. Drawings account, as a expenses, debit balance. You understood how to do balancing here, it's very important. It's a ledger posting and balancing. Okay, I hope that this, according to this exercise, you understood the detailed part about preparation of general entry and simultaneously how you have done your ledger posting. Thereafter, finally, the balancing. So, what is the meaning of by balance carried on, by two balance brought on? Okay. So, I hope that you understood this session. It's a very, very important one. You please watch number of times done only and able to understand the ledger posting and balancing. Then, your remaining in exercise is very easy for you. Okay. I hope that you understood. Okay, thank you very much.